Hello everyone and welcome back to the channel. Welcome to Marty's Corner. I am Marty. Welcome back to Washington, D.C. Today's going to be a little bit of a different feeling of a vlog. Today we are going to be touring the National Holocaust Memorial Museum, which is right behind me. The things that you're about to see are reflective of some of the worst parts of humanity that we have experienced in our world, and in many countries are still going on today. Originally, I was thinking maybe I shouldn't do this vlog, maybe I should just, you know, go in and tour it again. But then I thought to myself, this is something that everybody needs to see because we need to study and remember our past so future doesn't repeat itself. So with that said, there are many things inside of this museum that may not be suitable for younger audiences and children. So for that sake, I say viewer discretion is advised. To get into the museum, you now do need to go online and get your tickets in advance. There is a $1 processing fee, but other than that, it is free. So I hope you are ready. Get your tissues out, because I'm probably going to need it myself. This is the National Holocaust Memorial Museum.
আগুন মরা ইন্ডিয়ান ডেলতে দেখি আজকে ভীষণ ফরি মাথা করি ফরি দেখো আজ এত হতাম বাজে উগুয়া ধো আন্দাজ বাজিব মুসমিক কেউ ইয়ায় সাইদে আর ভাই মাহমুদুল হাসান কে এসছে আসছে আয় রে আর ডাকিস আর ডাকে আয় কি মাতি ইতে কি মিলিটারি তার কেন দেখে হুনে হারি তে কেমুরি আসছে আর আয় হুনে হারি ডর লাগে মানে
তার বারো কি
মানুষ গত আসলে বেড়ে গুফাদ
মানে ডুমাই বা করালাম তালুদ্দিন মুরাদ মারে এর তাকি এর তাকি বাদে কুয়াইবা হব স্যার দে রে গাদিয়া মুরা
Bena eden rüyar. Bena aşklarından bazı bu. Ara görme de ar bay teyli ver ara ki görme batı de uşi. Batı de uşi de mazda dikke manuşu da ar görür mundu duğur ifar odur durdu. E kiye de her ufuzar bir girahada milletteye gitti. Milletteye gitti her an milletteye inen o esayi biliyor. Zaten mazda gulur arak da her kirli tutsar. সাইদে মেরে ক্লাস আর গো সাইড আপ তুই গি
বাদা আর আর সিরা গোর একটা মাঝে মোর ফোন রু বাঁধি বাঁধি আর উগুর গুর করে আইছে
দরি আর বাড়ি দিস ফিস সব বানি না রে বারে উগুর না রে মারে দর লে উশ মারে পাল তুই রে যাতে সব গো উড়া আমি যেতে রে এড়ে বানি বানি ভালো আইছে রে মানুষ আর আর যে তাদি বেলি রে বানি ভালো আইছে তো বাদে তো বাই হবে তারা তো না পুঙ্গো যে পুঙ্গো রে হবে আগুন হতে কে সামনে তো তুই হবে নিসাই ভাদ্র দুজন যখন দুটি দিন আগে গুলি দিয়ে দেয় গুলি মারে
করিয়ানো পর বাদে জনে জন ডাকে আর ডাকিয়ার বাদে মিনিটে ডেঙ্গুর বাতি ধরে দেখে বাজু বুদ্ধি নাই ধরে দেখে ইঙ্গুর বাজু ধরে দেখে বাজু ধরে পুতর বাতি মারে দেখে ভূষা মারে এটার কেস কাজা মতো মাই বেঁধে তো মাথা হলে দিন কাল ভাঙে ফেলে এটার আরে শুভ মাঝে পালাশ কাটতে ফেলে এত তো হিসা বাঙা
আর তিনি বাইরে কিনারে যদি তুমি খুদুম খুদ্দু বাদ বাদে দেখি যদি আরো আর তো বাদ অত মাদারে দিই পুরো কাহা সালে বড় বিড়া
City no longer the country's proud old capital, but a new outpost in the
and many other passengers also policies. A federal judge ordered the ship to stay in Norfolk while Morowitz's case was reviewed by the courts. While the ship waited in Norfolk, the State Department investigated the remaining passengers. All were allowed to disembark in the United States. The Kwanzaa passengers sent letters of gratitude to the State Department and the White House, including flowers for the First Lady. But Assistant Secretary of State Breckinridge Long was angry about being forced to admit refugees from the Kwanzaa. He made it clear to U.S. consulates in Europe that the State Department would not tolerate any further incidents in the future.
Keep out of this war. I believe that it will.
President Roosevelt signing the neutrality bill, Vice President Garner and other supporters of the act are present on the historic occasion when the cash and carry plan is officially inaugurated.
In the event of war in Europe, I think we should stay out of this entirely.
I am the prime guardian of European affairs.
Not a war, not for me. This kind of magic to keep out, and I know I will.
Nothing the market can hit the fat, speed, hot, army, and food and all this.
Our present program will train 800,000 additional men this coming year. It is a program of defensive preparation only.
Like most men of my age, I have made plans for a private life of my own choice. These plans have been made in a world that now seems as distant as another planet.
For the first time in the history of the nation, we have a third-term presidential candidate. And this presents a crisis purely American.
If you be elected, you may expect war in April 1941.
The first president ever elected for a third term, Franklin Delano Roosevelt.
If Great Britain goes down, the Axis powers will be in a position to bring enormous military and naval resources against this hemisphere. We must be the great arsenal of democracy.
We will send you in ever-increasing numbers, ships, planes, tanks, guns. That is our promise and our pledge.
At the White House, tickets. 24 hours a day, tickets of the American Peace Mobilization march protesting against the national policy.
In New York, Charles A. Lindbergh, who has since submitted his resignation as colonel in the Army Air Force, speaks to a rally of the America First Committee.
I have been forced to the conclusion that we cannot win this war for England, regardless of how much assistance we send. That is why the America First Committee has been formed. There are some timid ones among us who say that we must preserve peace at any price, lest we lose our liberties forever. To them, I say this. Our freedom has shown its ability to survive war, but our freedom would never survive surrender.
The danger of the Roosevelt administration lies in its subterfuge. They have led us to war, heedless of the platform upon which they were elected. We are on the verge of war, but it is not yet too late to stay up. If the British, the Jewish, or the administration stops agitating for war, I believe there will be little danger of our involvement.
December 7th, 1941, a date which will live in infamy.
We are now in this war. We're all in it, all the way. Every single man, woman, and child, the partner, the most tremendous undertaking of our American history.
The Assistant Secretary of State, Breckinridge Long, was angry about being forced to admit refugees from Kwanzaa. He made it clear to U.S. consulates in Europe that the State Department would not tolerate any further incidents in the future.
Meanwhile, while the Holocaust was going on in Europe, and millions of Jews were being murdered here in the United States, we had opted not to get involved in the war until it involved us. This is what was happening in the United States during the Holocaust. Thank you. pretty heavy stuff, isn't it? I want to thank you for joining me, and if you got to the end of this video, then I applaud you. I know it is not easy to see. It is not easy to watch. It is not easy to take in. I have a personal tie with this because both of my grandparents are Holocaust survivors. They have passed on of natural causes. Since then, they were both in the Auschwitz death camp, and they would tell me stories, real stories, of their experiences, and they are the stories that you have heard, and they have seen the sights that you have seen in this video. I know it was a very long video, probably one of the longest vlogs I've done, but it's probably one of the most important as well. To think that mankind could do such a thing, and still does today in other countries around the world. We cannot be silent. And when I say we, I'm not talking about just the United States, I'm talking about the world cannot be silent. We cannot allow genocide of other cultures because a difference of belief. When you come here to the Holocaust Memorial, make sure that you grab the pamphlet, the museum guide that says it is a question. Also, you're going to grab an identification card. You can grab one for male. You can grab one for female. Inside, you will see the story of someone that was in the Holocaust. And as you go through the museum, you can follow their story and you will find out their fate at the end. Coming here, I see all of these tiles from children that need to know what happened. So it doesn't continue or ever happen again. And children are so innocent. You know, we see things like peace, never again. And they ask questions. Why? Why, mommy? Why, daddy? Why would something like this ever happen? I don't know, but I hope it doesn't happen again. I hope it stops happening around the world. But we as humans, we have to band together, and we need to make that happen. In our own country alone, we are divided between red, blue, different party systems, and we are at political war within ourselves. And it needs to stop. It needs to stop. Because right here, the future belongs to our children. What do we want for them? Again, thank you so much for joining me on this very somber, but educational and much needed reality check. If you like this video, appreciate this video, please make sure to subscribe to the channel, give it a like. And if you're gonna share any video, this would be a really good one to share because we can never forget. I love you guys. Take care of yourselves and each other.